Hey guys, you know what time it is? It's Wednesday, so it's a coffee time with Cobra. Yeah, is it a Han or a is it a Han day or a Fet day? I don't know. It's a meh day. Now normally I do this on the back porch, but today it's too bloody cold to do it on the back porch, so I am doing it here in my office, which is a complete mess. Which I will be cleaning up pretty much today. Got a little bit of bad news from a family friend. I'm not willing to share it right now. Again, not without their permission. One of the things I like to do, guys, is if I'm going to be sharing any news about, you know, births, deaths, you name it, what I tend to do is I tend to get the approval first of the person. You know, I really do. I like to get the approval of a lot of it's just a respect thing. You know, it's just a respect thing. And sorry, my fist balls is going nuts. And so I'm not willing to go into the details what it is, but how have you been? Me? I'm doing great. I've got a cat staring at me. No, that's not my cat. And yes, that is a motherboard it's sitting on. Don't ask questions. Don't judge me, monkey. You know. Did my first cow aesthetics / CrossFit exercise yesterday. Well, actually I did it last night before I went to bed. I had too much energy pent up. If I drink coffee past 7 o'clock, I don't sleep, like, damn near at all. For some reason, my body's like, no, you shall not sleep. God, I've got bags. I've got bags from hell. Anyway, stress. Anyway, so yeah, I had a little bit too much energy left up in me, and so grabbed my Muscle Milk, grabbed some Gatorade. Don't mix it together, it's not good, but I use my Muscle Milk pre and post workout, my Gatorade during my workout, and did a 2.5, well, it's supposed to be a 2.5 times CrossFit thing, and it was okay. I mean, it worked my shoulders, my obliques, my biceps, triceps, my quads, it worked the areas I want to do. Did some crunches, some sit-ups, did some planking. I think I did a 6.5-7 minute plank, which is, oh my god, trust me, I was like, I want to die. Whoever invented the plank exercise, I want to kill you, you son of a bitch. But yeah, it was good. I like it, I feel it. I actually see it. That's the messed up thing. I'm actually seeing the contours already, and I know it's mostly a mental thing, you know. I know it's mostly up here, you know. It's a mental thing, but I'm actually seeing the contours already in my shoulders, the definition of my shoulders, my up here, my neckline, things like that, and also in my biceps. Not seeing so much in my wrists. I'm doing some wrist curls and a few other things to build up the strength in my lower arms, as well as my upper arms, things like that. Hey, whoa.
Hello. Yes, world, it's me. I'm alive.
Yes, she's alive. I didn't kill her. Yet.
I didn't die this weekend.
Oh. And so, yeah, like I said, I did a little bit of it was a 20 to 25 minute CrossFit workout. I'm trying to find words to explain what it is. I normally just do straight power lifts. Heavy weights, you know, small repetitions. For example, 100-pound, you know, bob, you know, 100 pounds on the weights. Do 5 reps of that, then 125, 5 reps of that, then 150, 5 reps of that. You know, and call it good with a 30-second rest period between each 5 reps, and that tends to get me to where I want, but at the same time, it tends to just tear up my muscles too fast. I'm trying this lower weights at faster reps thing for a cardio workout as well. I tried that last night as well. That's, oh my God, did it freaking kill my arms. If it wasn't...
Feel the burn, motherfucker!
Oh, I felt it. It felt like someone had rubbed freaking chili sauce inside my muscles. I'm still feeling it today, so I'm not like all the way out here because my arms are freaking killing me. Even with the muscle milk, with the repair stuff that's in the muscle milk, yes, it's not really like killing me like it used to when I was younger, but damn, and I mean damn, is it freaking, I mean, most people are like, you know, you ain't that big, and I'm like, no, I'm not, I ain't that big, but I'm getting there. I'm not as big as you, Bradley Martin, if you don't know who he is, he's a YouTuber. That dude, I swear to Christ, I've seen that man deadlift 200 pounds with two chicks on his shoulders. If they was to ever film a live-action movie of the Hulk again, like what they did with Lou Ferrigno, I'm pretty sure Bradley Martin would be in the run to play the Hulk. I follow him on Twitter. You know, I've tweeted him a couple of times. He's actually tweeted back to me. Really good guy. Lives out in California. And you know, like I said, he's a good guy. Big thing on social media. I'm really not comfortable that much yet. Once I get rid of my spare tire around my belly, because I'm a little bit loose around the belly here. Got some water weight or whatever it is. I don't know what it is. It's just stubborn belly fat. No matter what I've done, I just can't seem to get rid of it. I've already gone down from a 44 to a 38. You know, so take that as you will. You know, I've already gone down from a 44 to a 38. You know, and everyone I know is like, dude, how are you losing weight so goddamn fast? Eat less, exercise more. Duh. You know, plain and simple. I've lost it in the face, I've lost it in my neck, I've lost it in all the areas that I wanted to lose it. I just need to get rid of this damn stubborn belly fat now. Once that's gone, a couple of my dress shirts will start fitting me again, and I'll be able to start wearing my suits more. Yes, I own suits. Yes, this British redneck own suits. You know, I really got to figure out what's going on with my eyes, though. Oh my God. I'm not wearing makeup. I don't wear makeup. Blokes don't wear makeup. Anyway. Yeah. So that's what's going on. And I know today's Wednesday. I'm going to be posting last Wednesday's video clips in with this one. So this is going to be the intro to it, and then I'm going to post the last Wednesday's one, so you're all caught up. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I've got to refill my reservoir, and my editing rig is a little low for where I want it. It's going to start sucking air into the line here soon. So I'm going to have to shut it down today and pull that tank off and refill it. Distilled water. Distilled water. No need to add anything into it. It's distilled. There's no algae or anything in it. No kill coils. No nothing. You don't need any of that crap. Just straight distilled water. That's all you need. Not deionized. None of that fucking fancy crap that costs you a freaking fortune. Just go to your local grocery store and get a jug of distilled water. That's it. That's all I've ever used. That or windshield washer fluid. But with windshield washer fluid, it will turn your pipes cloudy. Especially if you're using like the regular tubing that you can get like your hardware store. It'll turn that shit cloudy. Like that. Like milky cloudy. But it doesn't damage the pipes. A friend of mine, Bucky, he's been doing that with his water cooling loops for years. Me, I've recently switched over to this reinforced rigid tubing. This stuff right here. Like I said, I've just recently switched over to that rigid tubing stuff. Simply because I'm sick and tired of kinks. And that stuff doesn't kink. You cannot kink that stuff.
I've tried.
Yeah. You cannot kink it.
I didn't believe it when he first told me, and I tried.
Yeah, you can't kink that stuff.
I even tried to tie that shit in a knot. It wouldn't let me do it.
Yeah, you cannot kink that stuff. That's why I love it. It's designed for high pressure PSI stuff. I've seen people use that in automotive applications when it comes to boosts and turbos and stuff. For the wastegates and things like that, where the regular rubber hose will just swell up. That stuff doesn't even swell. It's just...
I wonder how well that would work in a diesel pre-fit for flipping over to a biodiesel.
It might. Well, I know that stuff's literally like indestructible.
That's neoprene.
Yeah, I've seen people. No, I've seen people. It's Teflon coating on the inside. I've seen people run freaking E85 ethanol through that stuff.
Oh fuck!
And it hasn't even melted it, like it does with regular car hoses.
Yeah.
This is why I keep trying to tell Michelle, please stop putting 85 in the car, because you're gonna damage the tank and stuff after a while. You know, yeah, it's cheaper. It's cheaper for a reason, guys. You know?
It's cheaper because it's watered down.
Think about it, okay? Let me put it into terms that most people can understand. E85 is cheaper because it costs less to produce, okay? And so it actually makes most of the gas companies more money than it does the 90-octane stuff. But if you're a skinny person and you go to... Let's just put this into a perspective that you can understand. If your vehicle was you, okay, and you go to the gas station, no matter what gas station it is, Sinclair's, Maverick, BP, Shell, doesn't fucking matter. And you've got E85, which I would say is fast food, junk food, whatever. Then you've got the 89 octane. That is... I'd say at best a salad covered, and I mean covered, in dressing to the point where you just see a leaf, like a lettuce leaf, floating in a river of freaking ranch dressing, i.e. what my wife eats. And then you've got the 91 octane. Now that stuff is lean protein meat, you know, or everything that's just right for your body. Okay? What would you have? What would you want? Would you want the junk food? Would you want the in-between, or would you want what's perfect for you? Just saying. And no, I don't work for a gas company, before anyone asks. You know, I'm pretty sure I'm about to get freaking people saying, oh, you must work for the petrol industry. I don't work for the petrol industry. Okay, I work for me. Okay? Yes, I'm a petrol head. Yeah, I'm a gearhead. Yeah, I love cars, bikes, motorcycles, dune buggies, anything with a bloody engine. Hell. I'll get a semi-stiffy looking at a lawnmower, you know? But like I said, I like cars. I like anything that goes fast, preferably sideways around corners. Doesn't mean I like rice burners, I don't. I like taking... Put like this. One of the goals I want to do is I want to take... I want to take a classic muscle car like a Nova... Not a Nova 2, but a Nova, not the square body Novas, like the regular, like 70s Novas, like 69 to 72 muscle car, Pontiac, you know, Le Mans GTO, Nova, Chevelle, Monte Carlo, Mustang, Thunderbird, whatever, you know, I want to take and then take the modern equivalent of it, take all the running gear out of it, and put it in the classic. That's what I want to do.
What?
Think about this. Take a circa 62, 63 F100 pickup truck, and then take the guts of like a 2005, 2006 F-150. Take everything out from underneath that 150 and put it in the 100. That's what I would like to do. That way, you see this old clapped out freaking 60s turd of a truck, traffic light, and you pull up with your nice, beautiful, freaking, you know, Dodge 1500 Ram and think, oh, I've got a Longhorn and a 5.7 Hemi that's been detuned to crap. You know, and I'm like, all right, cool. And I just leave you at the fucking lights. Yes, I'm a Ford guy. Hence the shirt. But, end of the day, guys. When it comes down to it, this is going to be a long vlog, I'm sorry. When it comes down to it, put junk in. If you put shit in expecting perfect results. Do not, and I repeat, do not be fucking ashamed if you get shit results. Okay? Plain and simple. You spend hundreds of thousands, think about this, okay? You will spend hundreds of thousands of dollars to buy a house, right? You will spend, you know, tens of thousands of dollars buying a car or a truck. You will spend thousands of dollars buying a gaming PC. Yet you let your own personal health go. Just saying. Just saying. Anyway, guys, love ya, leave ya, ciao. Hey guys, coffee time. Cobra, but no coffee. What? That's because I got the cup here. Is it a fat day or is it a hand day? I don't know yet. Don't know. So you're gonna have to listen to the pour. Oh yeah. That's the boys. They're busy playing PlayStation. Or Xbox, or console, or something. There would be
trouble.
The
Jessie,
absolutely best female moderator I've ever had next to you, Kelly, and that would be Alea.
Hi.
So today is a coffee time with Cobra because it's Wednesday, as you guys know. Yes, I know I haven't uploaded the Monday one. I will upload that today. The missus is, well, the screaming voice in the background, as you guys have asked in previous comments, is my wife slash soon to be divorced wife slash soon to be whatever it is that's going on right now. I don't even know, guys. So yeah, she's kind of upset because some of the puppies chewed up her bras and her new shoes that she bought. Well, I've told her time and time again to stop putting her bras and her shoes and everything else up on the dresser where the dogs can get them. Okay, these are puppies, okay? They're barely a year old, okay? They're going to want to chew, okay? Plus, when they were little infant babies, like little baby babies, she didn't stop them from chewing on my shoes and my boots, my work boots and things like that, and I wasn't allowed to correct them because they weren't my dogs, they were her dogs. So there's that. It is Wednesday, March 29th, and it's 11:47 in the afternoon, well, morning slash afternoon. Reason why I'm doing this, I've been up for a while now, as you can definitely see, I'm not, you know. The reason why I've been editing Monday's Coffee Time with Cobra. Normally what I try to do before I upload the video is I show the video to people who are involved in the video, i.e. if I talk about Grim, I show the video to Grim to get his approval, or if I'm talking about whatever, you know, it's just courtesy. There's no point in me throwing up a video if that person wasn't expecting it, you know. It's called common courtesy and respect. And so this video today is just going to be solely about me. Yesterday I did a podcast called The Meta Podcast, where we talked about HNG's metadata, which is a video game I live stream on Twitch and things like that, and we talked about shots to kill. Now, shots to kill is how fast it takes for bullets to hit a target and to kill the target. And it's right there in empirical data where it's like, you know, 150 milliseconds. Well, problem is, if you've got 30 milliseconds of ping, you know, do you subtract that from the TTK or do you add that to the TTK? Do you see what I'm saying? And so, yeah, it got very controversial. People lost their temper in chat and in Twitch chat as well as in the actual Discord. We talked about what guns need buffs, what guns need nerfs. What guns, just in general, how to make the game a lot more fun. And I suggested a dev tool that lets us, the developers, Redomoto, they pick a map, like a skirmish map or an encounter map, you know, one of the smaller maps, not one of the bigger maps, you know, one of the smaller maps, and give us map-making tools, okay? Like simple little editing tools like units, click, click, click this, drag here, drag there. You know, simple drag and drop tools. You know, nothing too what the fuckery, you know. Just simple drag and drop tools. And then What that allows us to do is to design a map, a community map, and the community votes. And if the community loves that map enough, it gets enough votes, it gets put into the game. You know? And actually have like a little section which has got a little check mark. Community maps, yes, no. You know, you've got your regular, you know, encounter map, then your skirmish, then your assault maps, and right at the bottom where you got war, you know, you can have your war maps and then community maps right at the bottom. Yes, no. You know, you just turn it on and it lists what community maps are available during that update build, you know. It also encourages your fan base, your viewer base, your player base to make more, to do more. And who knows, they may say, you know what, I'm interested in video game design. I might want to go to college. I might want to go to university. I might want to better myself, you know, get the skills that they need. And hey, you know, you might be hiring at that point in time. They've already got a passion for your game. You know, it's not like you're going to be hiring an outsider who's mostly been doing Battlefield or Call of Duty or Division or Rainbow Six or whatever, you know. You're going to be hiring someone who has as much passion as you do about your game. It's winner, winner, chicken dinner for everyone, you know. And, well, what can I say? Stupid is as stupid does. As they say, beauty fades, but stupid is forever. So I would suggest, because I mean, this morning the Baroness kind of freaked out a little and corrected the pups because of her bras and her shoes and whatnot. And I already told her, put them in the drawers, you know, put them in your chest of drawers. She's got plenty of empty drawers. She just doesn't put them in there. She just doesn't. And it's getting beyond annoying. It really is. It's getting beyond annoying. For me, because I she'll go out, buy new bras every month. And guaranteed, like clockwork, all but one of the, and she'll buy like 5 or 10 bras, you know, all but maybe 2 or 3 of the bras are chewed up, you know, and I'm like, you're wasting money. You know, seriously, just do yourself a favor and just freaking put them in the chest of drawers, you know. But no one ever listens to Cobra, you know. The one making the most sense is always the one that's ignored. The one making the least amount of sense is always followed. Look at Donald Trump. That's all I need to say. Any who's in Susan. So yeah, like I said, this coffee time with Cobra is going to be mobile. So that's what I've got done for today. And Grim, of course, is sitting in here doing what Grim does. Yo. Like I said, when I do a coffee time with Cobra, if I involve anyone, I like to send that person a heads up and maybe even an unedited copy of the video. And oh, big thank you to Fud Cannon for the new intro. Fud, I love it, mate, but you misspelled deceptive.
And by the way, Fud, check out H1Z1 Fuck Newsy.
Yeah, check out H1Z1.
Cost you about $10.
$10, and you'll even get King of the Kill, won't you?
That's a separate buy.
Mm.
They split them.
What's up, buddy?
Do you want me to get the bathroom?
You having a shower?
Yeah.
You go take a shower, mate.
Uh-huh.
You kind of stink like a tuna house. Shit house door on the turnabout. But anyway, like I said, it's going to be an interesting day today. It really is, because I've got a friend, and my wife keeps, my ex, whatever you want to call her, she keeps dropping hints as if I'm trying to date her or something. Listen, guys, I'm not dating anyone. I don't want to date anyone right now. I'm in love, but what I'm in love with, I can't have sex with. Trust me. I can't.
Well, you could stick it in the tailpipe. You just have to use extra.
Did you see that video where a guy actually did that in Mexico? Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. If you guys are wondering, it's a 2005 Dodge Magnum SRT. Okay? It's the Dodge Charger thing with the hatchback. Okay? That's what I'm in love with. To the point where I've looked at getting body kits and different headlights and everything else. You can ask this man here. I've been pricing it up, shipping and everything. I've even contacted a freight company that can get it shipped back to the UK. So I'll be driving a 2005 Dodge Magnum. I think it's probably going to be the only Dodge Magnum in England. And why? Gross gore. Yeah. I think I might start a dank meme here. Plain and simple. Yes, I started the first fire by adding the whole I'm more, you know, I make gross gore look like a man child, which I do. Okay. But he's going off about how his Supra has 500 horsepower. Guess what, motherfucker? 05 Dodge Magnum SRT with the RT Rally package, 595 horsepower. Little tweaks I'm gonna do, a couple of precision turbos, yeah. Precision 68mm turbos. Fuck your little pissant 35mm turbos. My one turbo is twice the size of both of yours combined. Yeah, I'll be lucky if I ain't pushing 1100. Street ball. Pump gas. Me, you, M25. Whoever gets nicked first by the police loses. Oh, is that the gauntlet smacking you in the face? I wouldn't know, your nose is too big.
Even after he had rhinoplasty.
Mm-hmm. More like hymenoplasty to fix his mangina.
Oh, me and my girlfriend broke up, but I got a new girlfriend.
Dude, you change girlfriends like gay guys change condoms in fucking pornos, right?
You change girlfriends more than NASCAR drivers change oil.
Oh, look, another left turn. But look, at the end of the day, guys, yes, it's a given. I would love to stay here in the US, but I can't. Okay, let me explain how the visa system works, and it is broken. Yes, I have been in the US for 14 years, okay? I love it here, okay? Trust me. Second chin. I love it here. But the problem is, I can't stay here if I file for a K-1 visa. Now, a K-1 visa allows me to marry a US citizen, okay? I already filed for a K-1. That's how I got married. Point is, my K-1 expired. But as it expired, my marriage got approved. So that's why INS/ICE can't kick me out, because they already pre-approved me to stay. But because I'm going through a divorce right now, I'm losing my ability to stay. So if I file for a K-3, which I believe is an employment visa, or whatever, I have to find a sponsor, which means I have to find someone who's willing to hire me and show to the immigration office that the reason why they're hiring me is because of my skill sets. Okay, I can't just say, oh, I'm hiring this guy because he's my best friend and I want him to stay in the US. That's not how it works. Okay? So,
whatever. If that's the case, I'd start streaming again and I'd say he's hired for a fucking stream manager.
And that's the thing, okay? I have looked that up and that is actually technically possible.
I know.
But you have to show that you make enough income.
I know.
Which you don't.
I know.
It kind of sucks. But like I said, long story short, guys, okay, or short story long, however you want to put it. Let me explain something. I'm going back to England because I am choosing to go back to England. I want to go back to England. Now, yes, if you look at my previous broadcasts, my previous podcasts, my previous live streams, my previous freaking YouTube videos, I've said I hate England. I never want to go back. Never say never, guys. The reason why I want to go back is simply because I miss my daughter, okay? I don't talk about her on live stream simply because I respect her privacy. I don't talk about her during my vlogs unless it's in passing, simply because I respect her privacy. But most importantly, I want to go back home to see my daughter, to see my family before my grandmother, who just reached 100 years old, guys. 100 years old. My nan, my grandmother, is 100 years old. Do you understand that? Do you understand the frailty of mortality now? I want to go home. I want to put my arms around her. I want to give her a hug. I want to give her a kiss. I want to let her know that I love her. Same as my older brother, Scott, who I've never met, except for in passing. I want to meet him. I want to meet his kids. I'm an uncle, and I've never met my nephews, you know? I want to meet them. I want to meet his wife. I want to go back and hang out with my crazy friends. You guys think I'm crazy? Who do you think made me crazy? Kenny Cannon. He made me crazy. Okay? Phil Keach. He made me crazy. Susan Lovesay. She made me crazy. Okay? Sharon Thurngood. She made me crazy. Okay? Trust me. You think I'm mad? Wait till you see my friends. Okay? And they're not afraid of being on camera and whatnot. They'll be in my coffee times with Cobra. I'm taking this camera with me because it charges via USB. So when I get my laptop, I just go diddly-dit, diddly-dit, done. You know? and I can upload still, can upload these vlogs, I can upload, you know, I can make YouTube content, just not video games or anything else, stuff like that. Unfortunately, I can still be able to do my podcasts, I'll still be on Discord, I'll still be on Facebook and everything else, and social medias and Instagrams and whatnot. And guys, listen, right, let me explain something to you. Yes, I know a lot of really good looking women, okay? No, I am not hooking up with any of them, okay? Reason why I'm not hooking up with any of them is because the majority of them have men in their lives, and I don't break up relationships like that, okay? Now, the moment some of them say, oh, I'm not with a bloke anymore, you better believe I'm gonna slide into that like I'm stealing third. Yes, that's a baseball reference. But ultimately, right now, I just wanna work on me. I wanna work on me, I wanna build me back up, okay? And the only way I'm gonna do that is to get away from everything that reminds me of what's dragging me down. And it has nothing to do with Grim. I love you, brother. You know I do, with all my heart, okay? With all my heart. I love this country with all my heart. Hell, I was more than willing to sign up to the US Army, okay? And that's when everyone kept asking me, well, what if England and America went to war? It would be over in a fucking fart and a gale because you've got nukes. Yeah, England has nukes, but they might as well be V2 rockets compared to the shit you guys got.
Put it like this, at one point, me and Cobra both were talking about going into the goddamn National Guard when I got down here. Then we found out, oh, age cut off at 35. Fuck.
Indeed.
But and like, I wasn't going into the goddamn Air Force Reserves. Fuck the Blue Falcons.
Mm-mm. But like I said, guys, okay, I do love America. I do love everyone here. Yes, I even still have nothing but love and support from my wife, my ex-wife, whatever you want to call her. Okay, I've got nothing but love for the Baroness. Okay, even though she's done what she's done, you know, we did. It's over. Okay, it's done. It's over. You know, that's it. Move on. Okay, I'm moving on past it. She's moving on past it. It's over. Okay, it's done. Okay, there. I'm past the point where I. When you first break up with someone, okay, you start thinking to yourself, do they miss me because I miss them and blah, 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 blah. Here's a hint. If they've dumped you, they don't want nothing to do with you. Okay? They don't miss you. They don't care about you. They don't give a fuck about your feelings. They don't care. Okay? They've moved on. So you know what? You should move on. Don't wait around for a train that's never going to come. Madness. Okay? The band Madness, just waiting for the train that never comes. Google the song. Okay? It's a tragic song that if you can relate to it, it will make you cry, usually in the first series of lyrics, okay? But the band Madness themselves are really fucking awesome, okay? They're a British band, punk band. They started off as a punk band and ended up becoming like a sort of hip-hop. I wouldn't say like Beastie Boys, but you know what I mean? Their music tastes changed, you know?
Yeah, kind of like what Linkin Park's doing. And by the way, Linkin Park, I don't like where you're going!
The whole Christian thing?
Oh, no. They started as a Christian band, but it's like their new album, it's like all like new metal slash pop shit.
Yeah. Ducky, ducky morning. Yeah. Fucking J-pop wow crap. Now, again, let me get back to the coffee time. Right now, I'm not dating anyone. If anyone ever tells you, oh, me and Cobra are dating, they're lying. Okay? I'm publicly stating it now. I'm not dating anyone. I have no interest in dating anyone. I just want to work on me. Okay? Literally, I just want to take some time off to work on me. Okay? This is my Death Star. Okay? If you don't know what that means, let me explain. There's going to come an opportunity in your life, at one point in your life, when you're going to feel like Luke taking on the Death Star. Okay? The Death Star could be a family member has cancer. It could be you're losing your home, or you're homeless, or you know, it could be anything, okay? It's your Kobayashi Maru if you're a Star Trek fan, okay? Grim's taken on two Death Stars, like
three.
I said. Three.
Like Death Star 1, Death Star 2,
Death Star 3. Yeah, like I said.
Freaking plant and freaking the Star Killer from. Force Awakens.
Now, my point is this. Okay, guys, listen. you're going to come across an opportunity or a problem in your life that you think is unobtainable. Like it's made of unobtainium, okay? You're literally going to think it is unobtainable. You're never going to do it. You can never reach that goal. You can't do it. Blah, 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 blah. All that negativity is just going to start slurping into your brain and you're just going to be a negative Nancy, okay? This is what I'm going to tell you. I'm going to tell you this right now. Don't let it get to you. Luke, Death Star, okay? Luke, Death Star, Luke, Death Star. Luke took down the Death Star. Think about that for a minute. Luke took down the Death Star. With all those odds against him, Luke took down the Death Star. Okay? You can too. You can take down your Death Star. You can deal with it. You gotta understand, guys, I suffer from PTSD and depression. Yeah, a couple of weeks ago, at the beginning of March, I tried to take my own life. And I failed at it. Let that sink in. You can do it. You can take that on that Death Star. You can beat it. Okay? Anyway, this video's run past the 20-minute mark. I still want to know if there's a firmware update for this thing that can stop that. Because once it hits the 20-minute mark, it skips and starts a new file. And it's not the file size. You know, because some of the file sizes are 300 meg, some of them are 600. It's just when it reaches 20 minutes, it goes click and starts recording again. And I miss out on like 2 or 3 minutes of the footage. You know what I mean? It's annoying. Anyway, guys, I'm going to end the video here with a stay safe, have fun, keep your coffee pouring, keep slurping it, and enjoy life, okay? Take on your Death Stars. Don't run from them, all right? You always want to be Luke, never Han. Even though Han gets the goal, but guess what? Luke's a fucking Jedi.
And Han dies eventually.
I know. Oh, no. Spoilers. Bye, snowflakes.